Shalom Chabrim, I'm Stephen Ben-Nun. You're watching Israeli News Live here. I'm with Dr. Steve Pidgeon here at the Georgia Guidestones, a very obviously New World Order monument in 8 different languages, several ancient languages also on the headstone of this monument here. And it's very interesting, the things that are about this. The man that had commissioned this to be built refused to really be known or share his affiliation of what group he was with that commissioned this. But as it was reported there, they had very deep pockets. And it is definitely showing a New World Order agenda there, a depopulation agenda, even speaking about that this would be here after the apocalypse, a possible apocalypse, with even supposedly a capsule buried here with more information that we're really not sure what is in there. But we wanted to come here while we were having the conference there in Georgia. And by the way, speaking about the conference in Georgia, just want to quickly let you know we will be loading the conference there, including the debate on the flat earth. I'm actually going to start with Dr. Pidgeon's closing statement from yesterday first, because there's no PowerPoint in that presentation. So we will be loading the rest of them, but it's a lot more editing work. I've got to include PowerPoints. Laurel also using video. We got to capture all that. So that's the reason the order will kind of be loaded in. It's the easiest first for me, and then the things that require more editing will come afterwards. But anyway, let's get back to the monument here that we're here, the Georgia Guidestones, and I'd like to have Dr. Pidgeon here share some insights with you about this particular place.
Well, thank you, Stephen. It's been great being in Georgia with you. I'm having a little fixins and some vittles this morning, a little bowl of grits, and being able to talk a little Southern. That was just terrific for me. You know, the Georgia Guidestones, when I look at anything, I like to look at what is there, and I also like to look at what isn't there. And, you know, it's very interesting here that we have the 4 large stones. They're in granite. And then there's a capstone. And in those 4 large granite stones, we have 8 languages. So, yes, we do have Hebrew. Yes, there is some classical Greek. Yes, there's English. There's Russian. There's Mandarin. There's Arabic. There's Hindi, etc. But you know what's missing is Aramaic. Now, it's interesting that Aramaic would be missing, especially when you have people asserting that the Gospels were originally written in Aramaic and that Mashiach spoke Aramaic, even though when Pilate crafted the sign above the head on the cross, it was in Latin, Greek, and Aramaic? No, it was in Latin, Greek, and Hebrew. Now, whoever the crafter was of this particular section of granite also omitted the Aramaic, and I think there's a reason for that. And it's because the language of Aram, that is Syria, was not the language of the Adama Kodesh. But as we look at these stones, Stephen, it's very interesting. You know, again, you have this concept of, you have kind of a static mindset, if you will. Let's put up some stones that are going to have eternal significance in granite. And yet we know that the 10 Devarim, the 10 commandments, were given on sapphire, not granite.
That's right.
But the Hollywood depicts it as, you know, 2 granite tombstones, but in reality, they were actually geometric shapes in sapphire. And so, again, we see that kind of misconception. Now, as we look on this stone, and of course, we're here on the Hebrew side and the Espanol side, mantener la humanidad en menos de 500 million. The population is supposed to be 500 million people. Well, there's 7 billion people on Earth right now. How are they going to get rid of 6.5 billion people?
Well, you know, Steve, they're talking about the apocalypse. So, you know, they're obviously they're anticipating a major war. And this is what we're looking at now as a possibility that we may be going to a major war, which could very well affect the homeland of the United States as well. And friends, let me just share something with you. I'm working here with Dr. Pidgeon, and we're going to be talking to Pastor Paul Begley as well about doing an emergency summit, prophetic summit, geopolitical prophetic summit in Orlando, Florida here. We've not figured out a date yet, but when we say emergency, because of the serious situation that's going on in the world today, we really feel like this is the hour we've got to get information out to you guys, share more with you, including some of these insights that Yana shared in this conference here. She actually got a standing ovation because of the information that she shared there was so critical and so vital, and so few people know about it. And that's part of a New World Order system as well that we're going to be talking about Steve, though, more, tell us a little bit more about this information on these stones here.
Well, it's very interesting that first of all, we have no commendation of the Creator. There is nothing concerning Yah, and it's so tragic when we see the Hebrew language and yet no tetragrammaton. And so you see this dramatic loss in both the spirit and in the knowledge that's going to be conveyed. But the first two messages that are brought forth here, one is for a radical depopulation agenda. And the very next statement here, again in the Spanish, guiar sabiamente a la reproducción, mejorando de la condición y diversidad de la humanidad. You're talking about here reduction of the population through managing reproduction and then balancing it with fitness. Well, this is a eugenics idea. It's a concept that's consistent with what we see in the New World Order, which is really a manifestation of the Third Reich, that man has the capability to transform himself into something superhuman, stronger, smarter, fitter, more healthy, and destined to live a much longer life than what the natural DNA gives us. And of course, that is one of the subjects that Yana Ben-Nun talked about during the conference to great acclaim, was how so much of what we see in the medical protocol today is pushing us towards transhumanism. And we in Washington, we see this as a promotion of the transgender identity. But the transgender identity is just one step along the way towards a total transhumanist transformation, which, by the way, will undoubtedly and most assuredly contain the mark of the beast.
There's no doubt about it. And it is a very critical hour that we're living in, friends. And the depopulation agenda that goes along with the New World Order is definitely in place. We know that the Pope of Rome recently said, when President Trump was meeting with President Putin over at the G20 summit there, after the Pope saw that meeting there, seeing that President Trump was trying to bring about some kind of peace and sensibility towards the relationship between the United States and that of Russia, Pope Francis shot that down very quickly, talking about it as an evil agenda that they were doing, and said that the United States must come immediately under a one-world government, and the European Union must become a one nation, also controlled by a one-world government. So this agenda is definitely underway, and it's been years that they've been planning things like this. This as it being as a guidestone, a guide to their new world order. Yeshua not involved in this. We see Yah not part of their plan whatsoever. It is a humanistic idea. They're going to try to fake a millennial reign. This transhumanism is part of that, faking that millennial reign with these nanobot technology inside of your body, guaranteeing you to be able to live 1,000 years. And at the same time, keeping in mind, many people will fall for it, not because of the transhumanism, but because look at the younger generation. They have so brainwashed them into the technology, computers, everything right there at your fingertips. Now you can have your computer on your wrist. You can put the goggles on, whatever the case may be. Well, they're going to put that chip in your brain, and you're going to be hooked up to a supercomputer. You won't need an iPad. You won't need your computer any longer. And younger generation, unfortunately, may end up falling victim to that if we don't do something and educate the people soon. I'm Stephen Benin with Israeli News Live. Steve Pidgeon, Dr. Pidgeon, any closing comments?
Well, I just wanted to say, Stephen, it's been a great pleasure to be with you here in Georgia and to share this time during the conference. I think the emergency schedule is very, very accurate, because we have arrived at a point now where, as we speak, President Trump is in a bunker and will be in the bunker until August 21st, when the super eclipse crosses America for the first time since 1776, it itself being a marker in heaven that's talked about in Genesis 1:14, that the stars, the sun, the moon, and the stars are placed in the heavens for signs, seasons, days, and years. And so we see one of these signs in the heavens now, this a total eclipse that crosses the United States 40 days ahead of Yom Kippur. All of these things are giving us an indication, certainly, of one thing. There's one thing about these signs that we can be certain. Repent, for the kingdom is near.
Amen. Could not agree more, Stephen. Thank you very much for being with us. It's been a pleasure having you, and with Zen and with Laurel as well. We really enjoyed a wonderful conference there. Be watching. It's going to be a last minute notice there. We've got to do a little bit more contacts there to get this conference together. in Orlando, Florida. Start preparing for that. We will be giving you the information on that in the coming days. I'm Stephen Ben-Nun with Israeli News Live. Shalom.